Hi guys, this is Calion, Maston, entertainment host for the Talk Around Town show. Now we're still on season break, but we wanted to come and give you guys a couple of sneak peeks into this upcoming season. So today I'm here with a dear friend, Miss Curesa Jones, and she is the owner of G Mama's Soul Food Catering. Curesa, how are you?
I'm great, how are you?
Doing fantastic, wonderful, and I'm a little hungry, actually, sitting here in front of delicious vegetarian food as such. So tell me, what is G Mama's?
G Mama's is basically a tradition of family ties. You have grandmothers, and every culture has them. And what we decided to do was honor our grandparents and keep the soul going.
So does G Mama's prepare, because I know you do catering, does G Mama's prepare specifically soul food from the African American culture, or do you guys branch out and will you do anything?
G Mama's, yes, we do prepare food from the culture of soul food, and we do others, whether it's Italian food, Mexican food, whatever you want, we do it.
Because every culture has their own soul. That's fantastic. So what is soul food to you? You know, I know, you know, I grew up in an African-American household, and there was always, you know, certain things being cooked, but that tradition changes per family. So for you, what does soul food mean?
Well, for me, soul food means having a grandmother growing up. And like you said, we all grew up, we all had certain food that we ate. And taking it back from centuries and generations, we can say that slaves, we had to eat certain foods that was left over for us to have. And you had to prepare those the best way you could based off of what you had. And that's soul food kitchen, taking what you have and seasoning it to perfection and making it taste just good.
Good, like slap your mama good?
Yes.
Now, no one slap your mother. Please don't do that. That wouldn't be nice at all. Then she won't cook for you. So we have here today what? What is sitting in front of us? It looks very simple.
It is very simple. It's collard greens.
Collard greens. And where do collard greens come from?
Collard greens come from basically like cabbage. This comes from generations of going in the fields where you were picking cotton, growing onions. You have cabbage, you have greens, vegetables.
Okay, fantastic. So how do we begin to prepare the collard green dish? I know, but our audience at home might not know. We've got a huge audience. So how do we begin to prepare? What's the first step?
The first step to do with your greens is you want to talk to them. Let them know that, hey, I'm getting ready to cook you and you're going to be great tonight for dinner.
Hello, bowl of greens. I'm going to cook you. And tonight, we're going to eat you and you are going to be delicious. Something like that?
Yeah, that's okay. You can do that. Yes.
Honestly, what's the first? I mean, if talking is the first step, you know, you talk to plants, I don't know, but, you know, so what do we do after we talk to them and make a fool of ourselves? What do we do?
You're going to open up the bag of greens and you're going to submerge them into the sink water, and you want to let them sit there depending on how many batches you have. They come in batches, so about 2.5 batches will probably give you about 4 to 6 batches of greens. Submerge them into the sink water and let them sit about for 30 minutes.
Okay, so first step is to wash the greens. And what we have now is our technology host, Dan Weecks, is going to be joining us in washing and picking the greens.
All right, guys, so I'm gonna give it a stab at this. So collard greens, I've eaten a couple of them before, but I've never like prepared collard greens. So what's the first step? What do I do first?
Okay, we'll come over here to the kitchen.
Okay.
And what you're gonna do is pick up that green leaf.
This one?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Now the trick is I'll actually do one with you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna take the green, and what you wanna do is actually peel the green leaf away from the stem.
Okay.
And you don't wanna leave any greens on the stem. We want all the greens.
Okay.
So once you peel them, and what you wanna do, we can set them right there in that bowl.
No, mine's
you're
not
doing a great
too
job.
Bad, right?
No,
am
not, really? No, you're doing
now, what about these like veiny?
Oh, no, we want those.
There. Okay,
yes.
You want those, okay.
And we're just gonna dump them right over there. And
then what about like right here where it's kind of falling apart? Do you want this too, the little one, or do I try
yes,
to do this all
we,
as one
we
piece?
We want the whole one piece. So
okay.
When you get done, it should be
wow, you're
almost,
done already.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You'll get the hang of it.
Yeah, okay. All right.
Good job.
And this is called, what is this called? This process?
This process right now, you're just cleaning the greens and
cleaning
getting them prepared.
Greens, okay.
Preparation.
All right, so these have been soaking for half an hour. So do I do the big one now?
Yes.
Look how huge this thing is.
I know.
It's enormous, isn't it?
And it's,
look at that.
Look at so, Dan.
And then
pink
you
and
see
green.
The little one that you just had. So the when you get the bunches, you might have some this long.
Okay.
Compared
now,
to.
So is there a trick? Do you come from the top or do you start at the bottom?
There's no trick.
Actually.
And you know, some
Calion
people.
Intervene.
If I may intervene. Yes, please.
I've got a trick that I use when picking.
How often do you pick collard greens?
I have not picked collard greens in a very long time, actually, since the last Christmas that I spent with my mother.
Oh, okay.
So if you pinch the sides like this.
Like with this thing
up the stem.
Okay, up the stem. Oh yeah, it just breaks away. Look at that.
It just breaks away. And it slides right off.
That would be good for sound design. That's like the sound of somebody breaking a bone or something.
Right. You like that? That would be a torn meniscus. Well, a meniscus isn't a bone. But anyway, so it's a lot easier if you do it that way. Okay. I found.
Now what about these? Do I just leave those?
Let me take a look and see how that looks. Well, you didn't do too bad.
I got like
that's
maybe
okay.
A D+.
I mean, because if you would have went any closer, you would have had the whole stem. So that's okay.
That now, what do you do with this whole four thing? Do you just break it and then do the same thing?
Like correct.
This?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Teresa, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think we have enough here.
Right? I will have to agree.
Okay.
Fantastic. Last one.
Last one. Go for it. Look how quick he is with that.
You'll get the hang of them once you do a couple of them.
Yeah, I've been doing it since I was like 14. Not even like 10, so.
Me, 8.
Great. So what do we do now?
So what you would like to do is, you have your water that's actually going to be cooking.
Okay.
And based off of 2.5 batches, you'll have about 6 quarts of water.
Okay, and it's boiling before you put the greens in?
Yes, and a lot of people like to use different meats, whether it's smoked turkey, ham hot, salt pork, oxtails. A lot of people like to
But it's another traditional.
Again, what was available, right?
What was available. Right.
Time, but a lot of different cultures use oxtails because it's simple.
Okay. So.
And then what you
want to
do, everyone uses different seasonings.
Mm-hmm.
Today, we have a jalapeno pepper, we have onion. I actually put in the pot Cheyenne pepper right now. And then we're going to have a little garlic salt that's already cooking in there.
Nice.
Okay, and you just want to dice up the jalapeno pepper. I can show you, or you can try.
Is this going to make him cry?
Oh,
no,
Dan
not
can
at
cook.
All.
We don't need.
Oh,
what our audience doesn't know is that Dan is a fantastic cook.
Awesome.
Wow. Wait to see if I draw any blood here.
Slice them pretty thin.
Okay, do you want the middle part in there?
No, I do not.
So just thin sliced.
Mm-hmm. And some people like to have them diced. Some of them I can just slice pretty thin. It's up to your preference.
Now, so last time there was any sort of pepper involved on our show was was when Calion dragged me to a...
Listen to this guy.
Well, okay, no, tricked, I think, is the right word, right? He got me to go to ATL Wings, and they had ghost pepper wings, which were
delicious,
the hottest in the world. Like, I was crying for 2 days.
Oh,
involuntarily.
No.
So... I mean, they were delicious, don't get me wrong, but I like spicy foods, but that was kind of over the top. So, how do these compare to that?
It doesn't compare at all.
Okay.
Basically, what you're doing is add an extra seasoning to your greens.
Good.
Because as the water is cooking down, you're going to add the seasoning to it, give it another about 30 minutes, and then you're going to take the greens, and you're basically going to dump them into that pot.
Okay.
And they'll boil down.
We've washed the greens. We've picked them. My good friend Dan Weecks is over here chopping jalapeno peppers because I don't like cutting peppers and onions. They make me cry. So the next step, we're gonna get it all together, and the water's already seasoned. We've already got the what meat is in the water? Is it
smoked turkey?
Smoked turkey, which is a lot healthier. I know.
Yes.
Growing up, we would use salt pork and things like that.
Correct.
Right? But it's a lot healthier to use a smoked turkey, right?
That is correct.
Fantastic. So we're gonna get this all together. While we're doing that, though, I wanted to bring up a point. I remember hearing that G Mama Soul Food is doing a special project. Is that right?
That is correct. We will be actually doing Feed 1,000 People. And
hold on. 1,000 people?
1,000.
You want to feed 1,000 people?
Correct.
For free?
Yes.
At once?
At once.
Mm.
Wow. So what brought that on?
It just came to me because growing up, you have friends and family. You hear about even more so now. Everyone's going through it, trying to make their left and their right meet. And sometimes you don't have that good hot meal that you want. Some people just don't know how to cook. Some people don't have the time. But for G Mama Soul Food Kitchen, why not get out there, Let's feed some people, whether they're homeless, whether they don't have any money, but let them go ahead and eat. Let them try your food.
That's amazing. So do you already have any backers right now who are willing, who are diving in and helping you guys out with that?
Yes, I have Shamrock Foods. So they're going to be our biggest supporter, and they're teaming up with G-Mama Soul Food Kitchen again.
Wow. That's exciting. That is super exciting. Well, guys, we're going to toss these greens into this pot and cook them up, and we're going to do some TV magic. And when we come back, we're going to have a sample. Our television magic, 2 hours of cook time has been cut down into a small commercial break, and we've got a huge bowl of collard greens seasoned with smoked turkey. So Dan and I are going to sample this. I don't know, I'm sure you've had some before, right?
I haven't had like soul food style collard greens, but I have had collard greens that were completely different, so this is interesting.
Okay.
Probably cooked a little bit like spinach, which they cook totally different.
That's exactly what they are. Yeah.
So, Daniel, my friend.
Thank you.
Now, one of the ways that we eat this, that I eat it myself anyway, is
I have a fork, by the way.
Hot sauce. Oh, I thought he had a fork. My bad. I apologize. I use hot sauce in mine.
Okay.
You don't have to. Another good way to eat it is with cornbread. We didn't have any cornbread today. But you crumble the cornbread up inside of it and just eat it with your fingers. Because it's really friggin' good.
It is.
I like the smell. Everything kind of comes together for this nice, like, full aroma.
It does.
So now how do we eat this? Do we, I'll try to get a little bit of the meat.
How about you try without the hot sauce first?
Yep.
So you can taste all the seasoning, the jalapenos, the onions. I'm going to try the full effect.
Kellyanne's a pro. He's just digging in right now.
So good.
Hmm. That's really good. Oh, wow.
Do you like?
Yeah, the flavors kind of develop in your mouth.
In your mouth, it takes a second, then all of a sudden, bam.
That's good. It's already got a little kick to it, too.
Mm-hmm.
I'll try it with the hot sauce in a second. When I get this full.
Because you like spicy food, so the hot sauce
is
even better for you.
Oh, it's so good.
It's so good.
And it's like, it's filling, too.
Mm-hmm.
It is.
Excuse me. So now I just pour this all in there?
Just
a couple dabs.
A couple dabs of it.
A little bit more. There you go.
Let's just do that, yep.
And it just gives it an extra kick. So, Curesa, if somebody has a birthday party or a wedding or whatever it may be and they want G-Mamas to come out, how would someone get in touch with you?
We are on Facebook for G-Mama Soul Food Kitchen. We are also email gmamasoulfoodkitchen@gmail.com.
Curesa, thank you so much for letting us into your space. And letting
thank
us
you. Yes,
thank you so much.
Coming.
And guys, thank you for joining us. We'll be back full time in a couple weeks with our show. But in the meantime, check out her website. Just look at what she has to offer and definitely try this dish because it is amazing. And with that, we'll see you guys in a couple weeks.